There's nothing wrong with you. You just require a different tactic. You require more direct stimulation, and there's a number of ways to accomplish that. And that's between you and your partner, and you decide what, how much, when that you need. Hey everyone, I'm Lucy Douglas. I'm owner and CEO here at New Beginnings Wellness Center and Spa in Ruston, Louisiana. So before I get started, I'm putting a graphic content alert across your screen. I'm issuing a disclaimer. We're gonna talk about sex, and I'm gonna use anatomical terms. I'm gonna use all the words in their appropriate context. So if you are skittish or there's someone of a tender age that doesn't need to hear this in your vicinity, just wanted you to know, save this one and watch it later. But I just want you to know that in the last 2 days, I've had two really deep, vulnerable, intense conversations with two different clients. One of them yesterday, her words to me were, as we started talking about this subject, she said, "Thank you for being so raw." And I've been called an oversharer by someone, and maybe I am. I came from a home where my mom was super quiet. Her way of dealing with problems and difficult subjects was to not deal with it. So if you came into my house with 7 kids and 2 parents, you would have thought it would have been a zoo 24/7. But my mom was just quiet, and she had her very particular way of dealing with hard things, and that was to sometimes sweep things under the rug. And so as a child growing up in that, I made some very particular observations, and I think I just learned that that was not particularly healthy. And so I think maybe that's why I might go to the very opposite end of that spectrum, where I'm very much an open book. I make friends, I think, pretty easily, and I want real and deep relationships, and I want real and deep conversations. And so I've chosen a profession and a style and a paradigm within the healthcare profession where I purposely meet with patients and schedule enough time with them to have deep conversations about the things that are important to them so that I can more wisely, correctly, carefully meet their needs and help bring peace in whatever area is not going well for them. The conversation yesterday, the patient knew that I was fairly recently widowed. And so that kind of led into, you know, how I'm handling the grieving process. And, you know, my husband and I talked about, he said, "I want you to remarry." You know, we had that conversation. It was a hard conversation to have. And, you know, it was hard to have that conversation with him when he was sitting right there by me. He was basically talking and I was crying. But now, 15 months into my journey, I can kind of see why he brought that up to me. I kind of, as I've thought about what I would like for the rest of my life, I've kind of thought, you know, I don't see myself being alone forever. And that's even scary to say right here in this room, and, you know, however many hundreds of people watch this. And so, you know, it is on my mind to have a partner to finish my race with and to enjoy my life with. And so that conversation we were having together kind of went a little deeper and a little more specific about, you know, how does sex fit into a relationship like that? And just being, if I'm being real, you know, saying I miss companionship. You know, it's hard to wake up and go to sleep by myself now for every day for the last 15 months. And so then this morning, you know, I had another patient, and she was of a menopausal age. And so in every menopausal patient that comes, there's this long list of questions I always ask. So we start talking, I start going through the questions. Are you having hot flashes? Are you having night sweats? Are you having vaginal dryness? Is there irritation? Are you having urinary incontinence? you know, and we're going through all of that. And then I'm like, well, tell me, let's talk about how's your libido doing? How's your overall drive? Because this sexual relationship between, you know, husband and a wife, and in my case with my deceased husband, the lady today, but sex between two caring adults in a committed relationship, I feel like I have a little bit of wisdom or a little bit deeper of an understanding, perhaps, of the importance of that. My husband and I, for the last 3 years of his life, we were celibate because the surgery he had was called a radical cystoprostatectomy. He had his bladder and his prostate removed. Unfortunately, that surgery caused him to be impotent. And so we grieved that. And it was hard for me to try to reach him because as a man, a lot of his identity, I believe, was wrapped up in his being able to perform sexually, not only for his own pleasure, but for ours together, and how important that piece of us was in our marriage, and then how we handled that when that was suddenly removed from us. And so that led into the conversation I had with my lady yesterday, and that was part of the conversation I had with my lady today. She was concerned about her lack of libido, and so that question led into, well, so if you do go on and have sex with your husband, are you able to enjoy that encounter? Are you able to have an orgasm? How is that all working? So I'm asking these very intense personal questions. And I think we're so programmed because we're, you know, we call this part of the country the Bible Belt, and everyone identifies, so many of us identify as Christians, and so many people attend church, and there's so much stigma that you can't say these words. And I'm here to say we must say these words. We must have these conversations. If we can't have them as friends, as husbands and wives, as partners, as healthcare professional to patient, like, where else should this conversation be happening? And so I looked at my patient and I said, did you know that this has been studied a lot, so you can go look for it on the internet. Greater than 70% of all women will not have an orgasm with penetration alone. And she was like, what? And this, she's 50 years old. I said, you heard me. Then that's not because something's wrong with you. That's just how you're made. Our anatomy is very complex. A man's anatomy, not so much. Very simple. A man's pleasure during a sexual encounter is pretty much guaranteed. I think we would all agree on that. Just the way they're designed. It's not bad or good. It's just how they're made. And so women, if greater than 70% of us are not going to experience the Big Bang without some additional stimulation, then can't you see how that would negatively impact a woman's overall drive, desire, libido? Because she's like, well, I hope that was fun for you. And you know, he's snoring and she's laying there like, hello? So I'm wanting to bring this out. I jokingly said to the patient this morning, we had such an intense conversation, and like, she was so amazed at the questions I kept asking, because this is pertaining to her personal overall health and well-being, but then it's affecting the relationship between her and her spouse, whom I've never met, but I want her to be healthy and happy and to understand how she's made and be able to speak up for herself in that relationship, and for me to be able to do as much as I can from my standpoint to help her hormones be balanced, that speaks a lot to her drive and desire, but then also to talk to her about options to help her in that area of attaining an orgasm. And so that's why I said to her, I said, I think I need to do a video on this. And she just fell out laughing. She was like, she told me I was hilarious several times. She was like, I think that would be great. I'll watch it. Because I just, you know, and the more I thought about it throughout the day, I was a little nervous because I'm not making light of any of this, and I'm in no way wanting to be disrespectful. It's a very sacred thing. It's just special. And it's an important part of a relationship. It was an important part of my marriage. In all the conversations I've had now for years with patients, I find over and over and over again that is validated. This is an important part of these relationships. I've had women come who have said to me, my vagina is so dry. One lady I remember clearly, she says, and I happen to know this lady and I know how happily married they were and are. She says, we haven't had sex in over a year. Now, all of you listening to this, how okay would you be with that? For whatever reason, like after we have babies, the doctors say no sex for 6 weeks, but a year, this couple had been without intercourse for over a year. And I know we could say, well, there's other things they can do. Well, yes, that's true. But I think there's something very special in that coming together with intercourse in particular. And so if a woman cannot tolerate that because of pain, that's something that I need to draw out of her. She might not come in here to talk to me about that, but I'm going to ask. So what can we do about that mad vagina? Lots of things. Every time now I see this lady who had the mad vagina and hadn't had sex in a year, every time now she comes in, my husband still says thank you. He says thank you so much. I've literally had a bouquet of flowers show up on my laptop from a husband. So I know that this is important and I've lived it. I've lived the sadness of that being jerked out from under us and how we struggled to come to terms with that and how that affected our intimacy and our communication and our ability to even navigate that cancer journey with the ultimate outcome being that he didn't make it. I'm telling you, this is important. I'm writing a book. I've just like, here it is. Here's the title of my book. Are you ready? Remember, graphic content. The Orgasm is Lanyap. Celibacy within marriage. I'm kind of struggling with that title, but The Orgasm is Lanyap is definitely going to be part of it. It'll be on Christian bookshelves everywhere. It'll be a mad seller. And so we just need to be honest with each other and that this is a part of every adult relationship. Certainly married relationships, you have kids, so we all know you've had sex, okay? So calm down that I'm not airing your laundry. It's just a known thing. And so our sexual health and wellness is part of our mental health and wellness. And I've seen how lack of drive and libido, lack of ability to perform affects so many other facets of the relationship. And so the dry, irritated vagina can be addressed with various creams. Sometimes those are effective. Sometimes we have to do some other things. Now, here at New Beginnings, I have the radio frequency. I have the form of V. So using radio frequency, I'm able to go in to the vaginal canal and support and remodel that skin using the technology of heat. It's like a hot stone massage for your vag. And that heat stimulates collagen, so we improve the tone of the vaginal canal. We can positively impact urinary incontinence. We can certainly deal with the dryness, the lack of moisture. And then I can treat the outer genitalia. I can treat the clitoral hood and the urethral meatus with the radio frequency. And that just improves blood flow to those delicate areas and stimulates the urethral meatus to be more intact so that along with working on the inner canal can address the incontinence issues. And then with using the wand on the clitoral head to stimulate blood flow there to improve sensitivity. So let's have a little biology lesson. In embryonic development, males and females are the same until the point in development where the male's erectile tissue develops out in becoming the penis, and a woman or female, her erectile tissue will develop inward. And so all you see on a woman on an anatomical model or on physical exam is the clitoral head. But that erectile tissue has developed inward. So there's more there than you're aware of. And so making sure, just like in a man, we don't want early cardiovascular disease because that can damage the small vessels that carry blood to the penis, affecting the ability to achieve and maintain an erection. Well, that also, early cardiovascular disease in a woman can wipe out her ability to have an orgasm, and then also nerve damage in both of those instances. So there's all of that going on underneath the skin that I'm always looking for in attempting to address aggressively for your overall cardiovascular health, but for your sexual health. And then there are other treatments beyond internal vaginal creams. For the lady today, we had a lengthy discussion. I felt like she needed some help to improve her sensitivity. So we talked about her needing to have a conversation with her husband, how he can help her in that, and so how they can have a conversation during intimacy so that he knows what she needs. I don't know that these things are not talked about. Men just assume, because movies will tell you women are ripping the paper off the walls with penetration only. That's all you're ever exposed to, men and women. So women think that about themselves. They think, well, that's what it looks like. That's what they portray. Women scraping the wallpaper off the walls and looking like they're in ecstasy, and that's all that's happened is penetration. So that's not happening for me, so what's wrong with me? And that's what I'm here to talk to you about. So women, you don't think that about yourselves. There's nothing wrong with you. You just require a different tactic. You require more direct stimulation, and there's a number of ways to accomplish that. And that's between you and your partner, and you decide what, how much, when that you need. And so the cream that I was able to prescribe for my patient today, we laughingly call it scream cream, but its fancy technical name is libido cream, but I like scream cream. So this is a topical mixture of testosterone, something that is a vasodilator that will actually dilate those small blood vessels down in that area around the clitoral head, and a small bit of peppermint for cooling. It's this very fancy, technical, amazing mixture that you apply just a tiny little amount, 30 minutes before recreation, to allow it time to settle in and begin to dilate the blood vessels. And so then you go to town, and I'm telling you, I walk through the waiting room. I prescribed this to a 35-year-old mom the other day because we were having a conversation about her sensitivity. And I just walked through, she was here for something else, and I kind of looked over and I was like, hey, how you doing? And she went, oh my gosh. Like, that's all she said. And I knew exactly what she meant, and we laughed because she was like, woo, praise. Like, 35 years old. She just needed a little something something. Send her on back home. So we have tools, we have tricks, we have the things. We can talk about it. We can use these words. We can talk about your relationship, your intimacy. Men need to know that women are very complex. We're designed much differently than they think we are. It's not like this magic button that they're just going to accidentally hit without any purpose or intention. And here's my take on this. This is where I'm personally coming from. Men and women are designed very specifically. And then God says, go get married and live together for the rest of your lives. So during sex between a husband and a wife, or between a man and a woman, in order for that to be mutually pleasing, a man has to lay his life down for her. He has to care. He has to know, first of all, that she's designed in a very unique way, and he has to know that. And then he has to care. He has to ask questions. He has to investigate. Because he's going to have his orgasm whether he wants to or not. And there's more than 70% of women that will not have one without some additional help. And so that is iron sharpening iron. We have to know how to communicate with each other, because there's more to this whole thing that makes it wonderful besides just the physical part of it. And so it's that vulnerability. It's that compatibility. It's that trust. There's so many other things, and I'm not meaning at all to come across that I'm oblivious to that, because I can tell you that I am very aware of the complexity of that part of our relationship and how very special it is and how important it is to the overall health of our marriages and our long-term relationships. So I hope that this maybe made you laugh a little bit, that you were able to say, oh gosh, I'm not the only one. That just means I have to come at this a little differently. And Lucy, what would you have to help me? And that you guys as couples can have honest conversations with each other, because if you two can't, then I think that's a huge part of missing the beautiful part of coming together in those intimate moments. And so I appreciate my patients that are so open and honest and vulnerable with me and allow me to come in and help them so that I tell my patients, I want you to go home and rip the wallpaper off the walls. Like, I want to hear you screaming from here. Like, I want it to be fun for you and that you and your spouse, you and your partner enjoy all there is to out of that very special and sacred thing. Put your questions in the comments. Call and make an appointment with me. Do not suffer. Do not go for months and years without enjoying those moments with your spouse. And I look forward to talking to you again soon.